un po'. If you don't already know by now, Kalihito Gimpo, and welcome back to our channel. I know it's been a hot minute since we've seen each other. It's been a hot minute since I've actually filmed a YouTube channel. That's because life is my thing, but what can we do? I want to say I can promise that I'll be consistent, but we'll see. I can't say anything, like we'll genuinely see. But anyways, welcome to another book video. So today's video, I am taking out book shopping, which is my favorite activity. Right now, it's the only activity that gets me out of the house willingly. The others, I'm just forced to. This one, I do it purely because I want to, and I shall do it. Okay, the only available bookstore near me is Bargain Books, but I still don't know if I want to go to Valmore or Three Rivers one. I've never been to the one in Three Rivers, so I still need to go check it out. But high key think that I might go to the one in Valmore. Now the other stress, am I going to take a taxi or a cab? I feel like if you know me, then you know the struggle of me taking a taxi. I genuinely cannot take a taxi to save my life. And also, I can't take my car because my dad took the keys. But yeah, let's get into the video. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment down below if you have anything to say. Remember, constructive criticism. I repeat, constructive criticism. Enjoy. Okay, I want to do a quick fit check. So I don't know, will you stand still? Yeah, okay. There you go. So quick fit check. The top is from The Fix, the pants are from Factory, the shoes are from Sportsy, the bag is from Shein, the watch is from Samsung, and then the jewelry, I forgot my necklace, but the jewelry is from The Fix as well. This is a big ass ring, but I love it.
A few moments later. Two hours later. One eternity later.
After waiting however long, they're finally here. You live 3 minutes away from my place. And you literally took 30 minutes just to come and fetch me. No. Why did you bathe? Are you going to see your girlfriend or what? Yeah, because we're just going to the bookstore and then we're coming back. Huh? Mojolo the dating. After so long of waiting, we're finally going to the bookstore. Whew. And now I'm just already tired. And I'm trying so hard to avoid TikTok because Bridgerton came out today. And I know TikTok is going to try and spoil it for me. So I'm trying very hard to avoid it like it's the plague. Up until I watch it tonight at 10. And then I can log on to TikTok. But before then, I'm just going to post to get out. And that's it. That's going to be my day for TikTok. So yeah.
Truck to the plane, to the truck to the hotel lobby. Me, I go through underground garages, presidential suite on deposit, elevator up to the.
Might actually buy it just for the cover. It's like manga.
No. Light Lark. Think of Light Lark. The video for me. Back. I'm in love with him. The fact that I still have not read the series. But I heard it's good. I have most definitely not read One Dark Window. But I've heard such mixed reviews about it. So it's a 50-50. Pretty cut. I heard so many good things about this series. But they don't have the first book, so I don't think I'm gonna get it. See? I've never heard anything about this book. Like, if you've read this book, is it good? Like, I've never seen it on BookTok. I've heard so many mixed reviews about this book. I don't know. I'm feeling some type of way about getting it. Like, I've heard so many mixed reviews about it.
I don't know which one to pick. We have Chef's Choice. We have, I don't even know how to pronounce this. And then we have Cinderella is Dead. I think I'm gonna go with Cinderella is Dead. Cause what? Cause I genuinely don't know. It looks so cool. But is it the first, is it part of a series or what? But literally says it's 200 years since Cinderella found her prince, but the fairy tale is over. This is the one. Two books yesterday, and the reason I'm saying yesterday is because after coming back from the bookstore I fell asleep, but now I have to be somewhere, so I thought I'd just finish the video real quick and show you what I got. The first book I got is Cinderella is Dead. Do I know what this book is about? No. Did I buy it because of the title? Yes. And it sort of reminds me of that song, I forgot I was a bad bitch. tragic.
Breaking all the rules, cause they were only habits. Cinderella's dinner casket. You thought the shoe fit, but I.
Okay, we're back. The blurb says, it's 200 years since Cinderella found her prince, but the fairy tale is over. Okay. Sophia knows the story, though, off by heart, because every girl has to recite it daily, from when she's tiny until the night she's sent to the royal ball for choosing. And every girl knows that she has only one chance, for the lives of those not chosen by a man at the ball are forfeit. Well, that's tragic. But Sophia doesn't want to be chosen. Yes, bad bitch. She doesn't want to go to the ball at all. Not when she's afraid the girl she loves might be chosen too. Oh, it's a thing! It's a girl, a girl!
Hold up. Wait a minute. Something ain't right.
That sounded bad. It's not a girl on girl. It's just the girl ex girl. Pushed beyond breaking by a society that denies everything she is, Sophia sets out on a journey that will remake her world into one where she gets to choose. I didn't think that this book goes so well with this month, because it's Pride Month, and I didn't even know it was a queer book. I don't know if she's lesbian or she's queer or what, but I'm gonna find out. And the cover is gorgeous. Look at this cover. That's the other reason why I bought this book, actually. The title and the cover, like... But yeah. The second book I got... I actually got this book because everyone on BookTok just going crazy about it. And not in a good way. People can't stand this book. People don't want to read this book. People are like, this book is a load of... And the name of the book is Credence. I know. Like, I just had to find out what's going on. I love a controversial book. I love a book that has people all rowdy. That makes people want to burn it. So I got it, right? Plus, it's also a buddy read with my friend Naledi. I'm going to tag her. I think she has a YouTube channel. Yeah, I'm going to tag her channel down below in the caption. I was about to say in the comment section, so I don't know which one, but we'll see. Yeah, this was the blurb of the book. Three of them. One of her.
Okay.
And a remote cabin in the woods. Not gonna lie, I'm loving this book already. And I haven't even started reading. Let the hot winter nights ensue in the steamy romance from New York Times best-selling author Penelope Douglas. Miss Douglas, one thing about you, you never disappoint, Shay. Okay, I can't even read what that is because it's, I think that's a name or whatever. Yeah, I think that's a name. So I'm going to change it to Stephanie. Stephanie doesn't care about anything anymore. The only child of a film producer and his movie star wife, she's grown up with wealth and privilege, but never love or guidance. And when her parents suddenly pass away, she knows she should be devastated, but she's always been alone, hasn't she? Jake van der Berg. What is he, Afrikaans? Even the name of Stephanie is, I think, is Afrikaans. Are they Afrikaans or are they British? Or what? I feel like they're Afrikaans. But we're not there. Jake van der Berg, her father's... Who's me saying Berg? Her father's stepbrother. Father's stepbrother, okay. Jake! Did I say James or Jake beforehand? We'll see. Her father's stepbrother assumes guardianship over Stephanie. After moving to the mountains of Colorado to live with Jake and his two sons, Noah and Caleb. No. Stephanie quickly learns that these men now have a say in what she chooses to care and not care about anymore. No. As the three men take Stephanie under their wing. I'm sure they take her. She slowly finds her place among them. But lines blur, I'm sure, and rules become easy to break when no one else is watching. Well, clearly we're reading, but they each want her. Oh, but only one of them is going to keep her. Oh my god. Even Colleen Hoover commented on this book. She says, and I quote, Douglas's writing is as gripping as it is sexy.
I think I'm going to do a reading vlog on this video, but we'll see. Anyways, that is the end of my first ever book shopping video. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment down below if you have anything to say. Thanks for getting this far. Mwah! See you next time.